A group of Filipino seafarers files a complaint against officials of the Maritime Industry Authority over alleged misconduct and abuse of authority. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Robert Mano. Robert?
Ron, the United Filipino Seafarers, led by its chairman emeritus, Engineer Nelson Ramirez, has lodged a formal complaint with the Office of the Ombudsman against several high-ranking officials of the Maritime Industry Authority, or MARINA. The complaint accuses officials of grave misconduct, abuse of authority, conduct prejudicial to the best interests of the service, and violation of the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act and plunder law. The UFS alleges that these officials illegally approved the issuance and extension of special permits for predominantly Chinese foreign dredgers beyond the two-year limit set by the Marina Circular. The action allegedly bypassed proper regulatory procedures and unfairly favored foreign entities over local maritime stakeholders. Named in the complaint are Sonia Malalua, the current administrator of Marina, Hernani Fabia, the former administrator of Marina, Attorney Japet Dacanay, former chief of staff of the Office of the Administrator, Attorney Mark Pascua of the NCR Marina Director, and Attorney Rowena Hubilia, the director of the Marina Domestic Shipping Office. The complaint claims these officials extended the special permits without formally amending the circulars, resulting in significant financial losses for the government. They allegedly failed to collect penalties and misclassified dredgers, leading to undue financial benefits for foreign vessels owners at the expense of the local maritime industry. The complaint also includes allegations of plunder, asserting that the officials amassed for about 79 million in ill-gotten wealth by extending the special permits and not collecting required fees. The failure to collect penalties amounting to 3 million per vessel for 20 vessels or around 66 million provided substantial financial benefits to vessel owners possibly shared with conspiring officials. The UFS calls for the immediate preventive suspension of the respondents still in the government service, their dismissal or suspension over due notice and hearing, and the filing of criminal charges against all respondents for these violations. ABS-CBN News tried to get the side of those being complained about, but they have not yet responded. Ron.
That report from Robert Mano. Thanks, Robert.
Philippine authorities identify the suspects in the theft of an 88-year-old painting by the late national artist Fernando Amorsolo. Local police say a man and woman stole the piece from the Hofelenia Museum in Silay City last July 3. A 25,000 peso reward is up for anyone who can give information on the two suspects who remain at large. The missing painting, also known as Mango Harvesters, is valued at millions of pesos.
The Philippine Statistics Authority is set to conduct a population census this month. Our correspondent, Lady Vicencio, joins us on the line with the details. Lady?
Yes, Ron, the Philippine Statistics Authority will kick off the 2024 population census on July 15. The last census done in 2020 showed the Philippines has a population of 109 million. PSA National Statistician Undersecretary Claire Dennis Mapa said the conduct of the PopSen aims to update the population count of the country. Aside from the census, PSA will simultaneously conduct Community-Based Monitoring System, or CBMS, to collect socioeconomic information related to education, health, and living conditions of communities to be used as basis for government policies and programs. Updating of the listahanan, or the database of poor families used by the DSWD, is one of the reasons behind the integration of CBMS to the census. PSA encouraged the public to participate as the census and CBMS will be used for planning, resource allocation, and establishing development programs to address the needs of the vulnerable population. 70,000 enumerators will be deployed nationwide for data gathering from Mondays to Saturdays. Accomplishing the questionnaires for POPs and CBMS will take around 45 minutes to an hour, but the PSA asks for the public's cooperation. Refusal to participate in the census is punishable under the law. For CBMS, data subjects will have to accomplish a data consent form if they are willing to participate. PSA assured that all data collected will be confidential. The updated population count is expected to be finalized within the year. The PSA said 5.2 billion pesos has been allocated for the conduct of 2024 POPSEN CBMS. Ron?
Thank you very much, Lady Vicencio.
The world's first motorcycle powered by compressed natural gas is launched in India. Freedom 125 is viewed as among India's solutions to combat its worsening pollution problem. The government touts the motorcycle as cost-efficient, with its use of CNG, a cheaper and cleaner alternative to gas and diesel. India's previous attempts to cut vehicular emissions and reduce fuel imports have failed to produce significant results.